Well, gentlemen, here it is, time for count.
At 2:30 a.m., the prisoners were rudely awakened from their sleep by the night guard shift for their count. The guards were told to routinely perform counts to familiarize the prisoners with their numbers and determine that they were all present and accounted for. But more important, it provided a regular occasion for the guards to interact with and exercise control over the prisoners. There were several counts every day and night.
I had really thought that I was incapable of this kind of behavior. I was surprised, I was dismayed to find out that I could really be a that I could act in a manner so absolutely unaccustomed to anything I would even really dream of doing. And while I was doing it, I didn't feel any regret. I didn't feel any guilt. It was only afterwards, when I began to reflect on what I had done, that this behavior began to dawn on me, and I realized that this was a part of me I hadn't really noticed before.
The National Institute of Justice found about 2/3 of the nation's inmates will return to jail within 3 years after being released.
Early morning at the Federal Detention Center in SeaTac.
He's working by himself right now.
A single corrections officer is unlocking cells so inmates can start their day.
He is all alone in this unit with at least, I'd say probably around 120 inmates. He has no one else to watch his back.
It's exactly the moment the two inmates at the tables have planned for.
They know that it's the perfect time to take us by surprise. He's got his back turned and they jump up and start the assault. You can see him struggling to get away. I can't imagine what must have been going through his mind.
Inmate Sabir Shabazz, a pimp facing federal child prostitution charges, is armed with this pipe torn from the sink in his cell. This attempted murder in progress is stopped by some unlikely heroes, other inmates.
Those two inmates that stopped the assault saved that officer's life. He must have seen that as a miracle.